Rap.
What is going
yes,
on?
Yes, sir.
Coming to you guys
yes,
live
sir.
From Tropicana inside
Let's
the Drago Lounge. Shout out to Raider Nation. Get in the chat, my chat, Samoan Raiders chat. Thanks for joining me, man.
Man, shout out to Cody, man, for hooking your boy up, coming through to the Tropicana, man. We live out here. If y'all don't, man, we got the Raider Nation deep out here at Drago Lounge in Tropicana. So, man, if you're in Las Vegas, man, you still got time to come through and hang out with the Raider Nation, man.
Dude.
Raiders! Hey, man, the vibes around here is crazy, man. Shout out to my boy John in the background. But, yeah, Cody, man, we got a game tomorrow, man.
Let's show that crowd, dude. It's a packed house in here.
Hell,
you
yeah.
You guys can see the we got some GoPro footage on the crowd.
Sheesh.
And it is wild inside.
Oh, damn. I see myself live right now, yeah.
It's packed, bro. It's packed.
Right, it's a packed house. It's blacked out right now. Everybody enjoying this day. You know, the day before we go out there and whoop. The Washington football team tomorrow, man.
The football team.
Hey, we got to win this game. Go 7-5. It's not going to be an easy one, but I do trust that Derek Carr and this offense can come through and take this W, man.
Imagine being a fan of the football team.
The team without a name.
Yeah, hey, well, who's your favorite team? The football team.
Which team?
Yeah, go football team. Is that what they're going to cheer tomorrow?
I don't know. It sounds like
What do you even chant?
I don't know.
Nothing. Go football. Go team.
Go team. That's my team.
That's my team.
But hey, but you know Raider Nation is going to show out tomorrow at Legion Stadium. And right now in Trago with all the fans around here, man, this is only a snippet of Raider fans in Las Vegas. And you know it's going to be live tomorrow. And hey, I'm going to be out there tailgating. I know you're going to be out there tailgating.
Oh, absolutely.
So J-Lot. Hey, J-Lot, that's the spot to be.
If you guys aren't here tonight and you don't know what's going on, obviously, you know, being a member of the Black Hole, I am obligated to hit that J-Lot tailgate
Sir.
On the far southwest corner of the parking lots. Get in there, and I mean, they do it up, man.
Hey, they got to get prepared for this.
I had quesabirria tacos last week.
Did you really?
2 weeks ago. Have you ever had those?
Oh, no. Yeah, I did.
Quesabirrias.
I did.
Fire. And they're just grilling them up right there at the tailgate. That was, I've never seen that before.
Was it free?
Yeah, it was free. You know how Raider Nation does it, just like our event tonight. Free.
Oh, man. Free, absolutely free, man. Like I said, if you're in the Las Vegas area, man, come on by to Tropicana and party it up with the Raider Nation, man. It is live, man.
And shout out to DJ Mike Scott. You hear that music pumping in
yes,
the background?
Sir.
That's Mike Scott getting down, man.
Hey, man. And we got a shout out to another Mike out here, man.
Producer Mike.
Hey, shout out to my guy, Producer Mike, behind
Raiders.
Hey, you know, we be holding it down. Yes, sir. Shout out to the Raider Nation.
Get in there.
Yes, sir. You guys see it, man. And you guys, if you guys are not here, man, y'all missing out. But I also, yes, sir. I also want to give a shout out to everybody in the chat as well, man.
Yeah.
I see Jose up in there. I see Glenn. I see GMK. Sarah Phillips, man. Shout out to everybody in the chat. I know you got people on your channel coming through.
Likewise.
People on my channel coming through, man. It's lit right now.
IG Piney, I see Glenn Martinez, Prodigy, Donnie Gill. Was that Romero?
Yeah.
Hefe?
Yes,
man. We got a cheese fan in the chat. Weird.
Hey. Hefe is the only Kansas City fan that comes through on Raider live streams, man. All the time.
It's something else, man. Raider, exactly. I want you guys to drop some topics in the chat. Obviously, we're chilling in Vegas.
Yeah.
We're enjoying ourselves right now at Tropicana.
Yeah, yep.
But I want to know what you guys want to talk about. I'm just going to go ahead and kick it off. I want to talk a little Darren Waller, man. Obviously, he was ruled out. It was somewhat of breaking news. Raider Nation's sad about it. But
yeah.
I expected it. I mean, yeah. I expect him at this point. Obviously missing this week. I see there being a good chance of him also missing next week.
Oh, do you think? I think so.
You got to play it safe.
Yeah,
it's a IT strain. So there's no injury to it now.
Yeah,
but it can get serious if you're playing on something that's hurting like that.
True.
So I think we play it safe. I think we ride it through one more week, and then we bring him back
out. Yeah.
Unfortunately, it sucks because I mean, who do we got next?
Yeah, it does suck. It does suck, but I heard it could have been worse.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's a good thing because we should be okay with Foster Moreau out there. I mean, it's a good thing that we have a tight end that's capable to take over when Darren Waller's not able to be out there.
Yeah, no, exactly.
But, boy, Senor,
hey,
man.
Hey, Senor, what's going on,
yes,
man?
Yes, sir.
Get in.
What's up, Moose?
Hey, stand back there. They can't hear us.
We got Mr. Fitz up in the house over here.
We got a whole GoPro. Oh, Mr. Fitz. What's going on, man?
Mr. Fitz up in the house, man. Like, it's everybody's here. We got Senor. We got Gorilla Rilla. Man, we got Raider Cody and your boy Samoa Raider, man. So we out here, man, doing the damn thing right now, man.
We're loaded up, man. Make sure I want you guys to drop in the chat. Obviously, not everybody can be here. Look at me getting all comfortable at this point.
Yeah.
Let me
put in his shoes. We chilling out here, man.
I'm way too comfortable over here.
But, hey, like I said, man, I don't think we're really missing much without Darren Waller. I know he's our number one receiver on the team. That's not a receiver. But, like I said, Foster Moreau, I expect him to go out there and handle business, man.
Hey, exactly.
He's more than capable to.
Obviously, not everybody's here. I want you to drop in the chat where you're listening from. City, state, zip code. Country, Raider Nation's worldwide. You guys are tuning in from everywhere. My chat, Samoa and Raiders chat. Yeah. We're live on both channels. Let's get this thing going.
And I want to give a quick shout out to my guy, Relly Bo Gaming, for the $199 donation.
Yep.
He actually asked, is Mullen playing on Sunday?
No, not this Sunday. So he's most likely, without a setback, right, playing Kansas City.
Yeah. See, I see that he returned to practice.
Which is good.
Yeah, that is good. But most likely, he'll be back against the Kansas City Chiefs. I know we do miss him out there, but I do trust Faison and Casey Hayward to handle business. And I know Casey Hayward did give up some big plays last week, but this week I feel like we should be okay.
I love it. So shout out to Dr. Diet Coke. How do you want the offense to distribute the running backs? Heavy Jacobs or split with Drake? Now here's the issue. It depends on the run game. Don't get me wrong. Drake is great in the pass game.
Drake
is great in the pass game. He can kind of do it all. But what he struggles with is pass blocking, pass protection.
True.
On passing downs, he has to be there. So he can be that gadget guy. But that's the reason that Jalen Richard is starting to, you know, take some of his load. You know what I mean? Because he can pass block. He's saving those third down passes. You almost get a max protect mode out of just having your five offensive linemen with Drake back there, you know, just picking up the slack on whoever's getting by. I think we go heavy Jacobs in a sense.
Yeah.
I feel like our entire offense was built on John Gruden designed a run first, then pass.
Yeah.
Right? You establish the pass game by the run game.
Yeah.
But I don't think we're built for that anymore.
Nah, these past couple of weeks we've been struggling in the run game, man. And a guy like Jacobs that I would have thought that, you know, could carry the load. I know he's been in and out throughout the couple of weeks that we've been playing. But do you blame this offensive line a little bit, at least?
For
them not opening up holes and giving our running backs
in? I don't want to say I blame them, but they're just not being the same that they were in the past. We're so used to a dominant offensive line.
Yeah.
Now we're dealing with an offensive line that is average at best. You know what I mean? We're dealing with an offensive line. Don't get me wrong. I mean, it's a whole new unit. Guys are there that should have been there. We drafted a guy first round to be right tackle. Now he's playing right guard.
Put him at the guard
position.
Now we
got Brandon Parker, a guy that we've made jokes about this guy for 3 or 4 years, and he's still our starting right tackle.
But it's tough out here in the streets, man. And man, like, these flags that we've been getting these past couple of weeks have mainly been on the offensive line, especially that right side with Brandon Parker and Alex Leatherwood. And, I mean, last week we were lucky enough to win against the Cowboys, but we did have 14 total penalties, and mostly half of those penalties came on the offensive line, whether it was false starts, holding calls, and those are momentum killers for our offense. If we can't drive down the field, we got to do a better job, especially on the offensive line, and opening up holes for our running backs.
Absolutely.
Real quick, shout out to the people up in the chat. We got people from Wilmington, Cali. Raiders. We got someone from Scranton, Pennsylvania. Someone from the 707, man. From everywhere, 310. It's lit out here, Cody, man.
It's lit out here, man. And it's oh, whoops. Switching over here, but went for the crowd cam there.
Yes, sir. You guys can see it, man. A sea of black out here, man.
Place is lit, dude.
You know it, man. Las Vegas, man. Who would have thought this would have been our home, you know? Our home, man.
And we're establishing ourselves a little bit, man.
We are. This is the first season.
Raider Nation's holding it down here.
Hey, we are, man. And we're throwing a huge party out here. And this is the first of many. So, Raider Nation, man, like I said, if you missed this one, we're always going to have another one. I know my boy Cody always got something cooking.
Yeah.
Hey. Well, we just hope that this Raiders team can go out there and give us something to cheer for, and hopefully we could enjoy the rest of this weekend with a W.
Exactly. I see Tucson, Arizona, Manteca, Monterey, California. Jeez. You think we see Kuntz this week?
I don't know. Honestly, I don't know what the deal is with Kuntz, to be honest with you guys. I haven't kept up with him that much,
yeah.
But hopefully we do see a little bit of him in the future, for sure.
I'm in the same breath. Raiders 78. Shout out, man. What up, fellas? Do you think we put up 30 or give up 30 versus Washington? I mean, hopefully it's not both.
I know. It always goes both ways, offensively.
One or the other.
And if we win games and score in the 30s, we're always giving up 30 points. Last week, we won 36 to 33. We got to do a better job, especially on the defensive side of the ball, not giving those big games. Real quick, shout out to my boy Relly Bo Gaming for the $199 donation, saying, I blame the O-line more than Jacobs and Drake. Hey. I agree with you. I do agree with it, because this offensive line is not the same that they were last year. We missed a lot. We traded a lot of guys away. Gabe Jackson, Rodney Hudson, Big Baby Brown, you know. But Raiders! Hey, man. Raider Nation out here lit. Our offensive line has not held up their own. Hopefully, man. There's been some games where our running backs do a good job, but there's other games where they're non-existent, and Derek Carr has got to go out there and sling the ball around.
I agree, man. And even last year, even though we had the pieces in place, that offensive line was declining a bit. And to see even Josh Jacobs as a top 10 rusher last year, and have having the math put up, right? Obviously,
yeah.
PFF, everybody has yards per carry out there, right?
Yeah.
PFF puts out a stat of yards after contact. So if you take the yards per carry and you subtract the yards after contact, you're going to come up with a yards to first point of contact. And of the top 10 rushers, Jacobs was by far the lowest, averaging at 1.1 yards was his average getting the first point of contact.
That's crazy.
And how are you supposed to run a ball like that?
He basically running into a defender at that point. But we can only ask for so much out of Jacobs, and I mean, I know he's not the guy that will make plays when there's nothing out there, but I'm just hoping that he can go out there and play better tomorrow.
I see you, Donnie Clovis, California. Glenn says, put up 30. Yo, Samoa, what's good?
What's good, man? What's good, Chad, man? Raiders! Yo, Raider Nation up in the chat, man. Spam the Raiders up in the chat, man, so we know you guys are listening as well, man. Hey.
Telling you.
Hey, one thing I want to bring up that somebody brought up in my chat real quick is the coin. Do you trust the coin, man?
Dude, you know what? Look, I trust the coin whenever they say it's a W.
Yeah, that's the thing.
It's a W this week. I trust the coin.
After this week?
I trust the coin.
I don't know, because if they say we're taking the L, I'm not going to really believe it. But when we take in this dub, man, sheesh. We lit up in here, bro. I can't even hear them, but
crazy,
I know that the Raider Nation out here is having a good time, man.
Absolutely. The coin, dude. It is so amazing how it's been perfect through these many games.
Who would have thought, man? What, 12 weeks in and they're still perfect?
Still perfect.
Bro.
I didn't know that he flipped the coin for every single team.
I didn't know that either.
I didn't know that either.
But of course, the Raiders had to be the Raiders and, you know, bring something up into
it. If he's going
to
get lucky on something, it's got to be the Vegas team, right?
Hey, why? Hey, exactly, right? Hey, sure, I'll take it, man. Any kind of hope I can take, I'll take it, man.
Hey, that's all we live on. We can be 0-10. Guess what? I'm waking on Sunday morning. I'm like, we can get this dub.
Hell yeah. Hey, that Raiders cycle, man, we do it every single week. If they lose, we mad that day. We kind of feel okay on Monday, come right around the next week, and we're feeling like we got hope to win that game, man, no matter what our record is. So, I mean, that's why I feel like we are the best fans in the NFL.
Agreed. Raider Nation, keep dropping them questions in the chat.
Yes, sir.
I want to hear some topics. How's it going? We got some people in the house. This place is packed out.
Bruh, it's lit over here. We got so many Raider fans out here.
And we're going to do it a lot, man. I mean, hopefully we get back in here for the final game of the season.
Definitely.
Chargers game. Hoping to do something for the draft. We'll keep you posted, man.
Yeah,
we got a lot going on here.
Hey, the Raider Nation did show up, though, man.
We're
really blacked it out.
A lot of stuff, dude.
Ooh, let them know.
Dude.
Sheesh.
Black Sunday real quick.
Hey, shout out to Black Sunday, man.
Let me tell you here.
They got, sheesh.
I got this, switch it over. We're giving away these hats. So next time you come, we'll be doing all the same thing. All these hat giveaways, which we're going to be announcing here pretty soon. We got an autographed Charles Woodson jersey.
From the GOAT.
Mitchell and Ness. Legitness.
We got Black Sunday up in here, man. Yeah, a lot of good stuff to give away, man, to be honest with you.
How's the chat looking, man?
Dr. Diet Coke asks, do you think DeSean Jackson stays involved like he was last week? Man.
Yeah, I mean, depending on, so he's dealing with that hip injury, right?
Yeah, he is. That's what I heard, I think, yesterday.
I think it's a better safe than sorry thing.
Yeah, for reals. Hopefully he does play. If he does play, I feel like we need to keep him on the field, even if he's not going to get the ball, because just his presence on the field, I know he's not no Henry Ruggs, but he.
But he's close.
Yeah. He causes defenders to, you know, step back a little bit, open up our offense a bit, and give our other receivers a chance to go out there and make plays. But I would love to see DeSean Jackson go out there and play, hopefully get away with another touchdown like he did last week.
You know what's crazy is after we drafted him that first rookie year?
Yeah.
I pretty much, after kind of gauging how he was playing that rookie season, I thought his ceiling and the most comparable player that he could be would be DeSean Jackson.
For reals.
Like, that was my, like, not ceiling, I should say, but kind of his playing style. He's not going to be a go-to number one. He's always going to be the guy that takes the top off the defenses, and he's a guy that can run the intermediate to deep routes. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Dial in the footwork a little bit and open things up. And one thing about Jackson, he's kind of been the same thing as what we thought getting Ruggs. He didn't have a whole lot of drops.
No.
And he's got hands on him, man, for his speedster.
Yeah.
He's got hands on him. So it's really cool. I mean, maybe we're getting him at the tail end of his career, but I don't think it matters. I think he's got a couple years left in the tank, dude.
I mean, he did give up a fumble on his first game.
We're not going to talk about that.
Hey, but you know what? That's besides the point, man. We moving forward, man. He got a touchdown last week. I hope he could get another one this week, man. But DeSean Jackson, man, it sucks to lose our former speedster out there, but hey. It was a good thing that we went out and got another guy that could come in and fill in, at least for right now.
Yeah, PJ Maxx got, dude, just getting this place. Well, I mean, we're capacity. Whenever I tell you guys to come through and to get here early, you better listen to me because I think they got a line forming outside. I don't want you to be inside that line.
Bruh, it's really lit out here. Like, mostly every Raider fan that's out here in Vegas, man, they're actually over here. So, hey, I was telling y'all, man, if y'all wanted to come by and hang out, party with the Raider Nation, I was in line, man. We definitely
people,
partying
man.
Right now.
Just chilling. Yeah.
We chilling. Hey, we be chilling on the couch right there, just having a good time, man.
I'm comfy, dude.
You know what I mean? Say,
love it.
I'm just hoping we take. Oh, well, we better take this W tomorrow against the team without no name out there. Shoot, I know they're on a 3-game winning streak.
Who cares?
But it don't matter because when you're in Vegas,
they're due for a loss.
They are. And who better to give them that loss? The Raiders.
I love it.
Hey, they do have a coach on their side that's a little bit salty towards our organization, you know? Jack Del Rio.
And that's kind of a weird matchup. I'm glad you brought that up.
Yeah. I just thought about it right now because everybody's been talking about Jack Del Rio versus Derek Carr, you know? This is the first time that he's facing his former team.
And that's the only matchup, really, that I thought about all week because it's like, who knows who better, right? So what kind of influence did Jack Del Rio have on the defenses with his time in the Raiders?
Yeah.
How well does Derek know what that influence was, and can he beat it? And how well is Del Rio going to understand who Derek was, obviously really well who he was in 2016, 2017?
Yeah.
But I feel like his game has changed.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
You know?
From
he's playing really close to the same style as 2016, but I think it's a lot different. I think he understands the pre-snap just a lot more than he did in 2017.
Yeah, 2017, like that year that you brought up, he didn't have good O-line that year.
No.
He didn't have – and this year, he doesn't have the best – yeah. It was really weak. And this year, we don't have the best O-line out there, but he's still able to get the job done. I know it's been tough, and I know that you add a good defense now this year. It does a lot of good things for us, but, man, I just hope that we could take this W against Jack Del Rio. I know he wants this badly, especially because he was outed. He got fired, and I know he hasn't been the same since. I just hope that we could go out there and win.
Dude, just take the wind out of their sails right off the bat. Just blow the top off that defense.
Can we just
there.
Get another victory where we don't have to stress about, man? It's been quite a while, man. So somebody in my chat real quick. Dang, did I lose it? Oh, shout out to Dr. Diet Coke again, man. He says, does Antonio Gibson scare you? Our run D is suspicious at times. And that's absolutely true, man. Our run defense has been really bad this season. Yeah. I mean, we've been good getting to the quarterback, but trying to stop the run has been our weakness. And Antonio Gibson is another guy that reminds me of a little bit of, you know, Joe Mixon out there, yeah. A guy that did beat us single-handedly, you know, on the ground. That's a guy that we really got to look out for, and our defensive line has got to do better. Last week against the Cowboys, we actually held Zeke and Tony Pollard to under 100 yards. So if we can do that same thing this week, we most likely could win against the Washington football team, man.
Man, Dr. Diet Coke is two-timing us, man. He's in your chat and my chat.
Oh, is he? Yeah, my boy, he's just watching both sides like, hey.
Hey, that's legit, though.
Whoever can answer my question right now,
commitment
that's
right
going to be my guy.
Do you think Olsen and Rich call more aggressive plays, especially going for it on fourth down, with Trent out to avoid as many long snaps as possible? Yeah, Trent Sigg being out, it is a big blow for us. Interested to see how that goes. And, I mean, we haven't really shown to be aggressive on these downs yet this year. But I'd like to hope so. And I'm hoping to see also, you know, there's been a lot of Tom Cable influence in this offense lately.
Yeah.
A lot of early down runs, and we've struggled on it. A lot of passing plays that has Derek rolling out with not too many options. But, you know, it's taken the pressure off the offensive line. So maybe Ole, you know, has kind of taking the reins on this offense again.
Yeah.
You know, I don't want to try and throw anybody under the bus, but I think at this point, if we can get Ole and Derek back on the top spot of the play calling, that's where we're going to succeed. Put the ball in Derek's hands, put the ball in the air, send it downfield, because that's been the only way we've been successful this year. And like we brought up earlier, the run, establishing the run created our pass game in the past.
Yeah.
Now it has to be the opposite. We got to open this field up. We got to spread that defense out. We got to back them linebackers out. We got to open up the box, and we got to get Jacobs some space to work with. Yeah. We got to get creative. You know, no more just, here we are in a heavy, like, power formation.
Yeah.
Obviously, we're going to run. Yeah.
And you know what was good to see the last week? Mouse.
Oh!
Marcus, you know, getting into the end zone, man.
Hey, one thing.
The flying Hawaiian, man.
Even though that was good, you know what I hate about it?
What?
Is we haven't been creative enough with it. Every time he's in there, he runs. It's like, let him throw the ball. Let him get a little wild with it. Every time he's in there, he's ran.
They know that.
Maybe we're saving it, though.
But exactly. But I feel like we should utilize him more. I mean, especially in the red zone, the three-game losing streak that we had, we were horrible in the red zone. So I was like, man, this Raiders team needs to be aggressive. At least give the Ooze a chance to go out there and make some plays, man. And we seen it last week against the Cowboys. He was able to get in the end zone. And, man, I was hyped, man. I was really excited about that as well. But I definitely agree with you on that. Yeah. This offense, Greg Olsen, Derek Carr, they got to be aggressive. And that's the only way we won these games is starting off strong, starting off fast. And last week you seen we started off that game with the 50-some yard touchdown to DeSean Jackson. We got to do that, be aggressive, go down the field. And we can't be laid back at the end of the game like we were last week. I mean, we had the lead. Cowboys were able to come back,
keep
take it
foot
to
on overtime. The gas.
We have to, man. We can't let any other team come back and shoot a Washington team, like I said, that's been on a three-game winning streak. We shouldn't overlook them as well. We got to keep our foot on the gas brake. On the gas, and keep scoring the ball, man.
Absolutely. Shout out to Donnie Gill in the chat. Wish I could be out in Vegas with y'all. Thanks for what you guys do. Let's get the W tomorrow.
Raiders! Let's get it. Man, y'all can hear them, man. Raider Nation is lit out here, man. Let's go. And we actually got one Washington fan up in here. I don't know why he's here, but I know he low-key want to be a Raider fan.
Who?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Yeah, he ain't gonna last very long.
He lost, man. I know dang well he wanna wear a black jersey pretty soon, man.
Yeah, he's like, go football team. Like, okay, go football team.
He's like, who's your team? The football team.
The football team.
Which football team?
Go team.
The football team.
The football team. No, like literally the football team. Every time I read the WFT.
I can't hear.
I can't hear anything. Man, I'm telling you something.
Man, I can't hear anything right now.
It's all good. I did hear if he said, there's a lot going on. I see Raiders in the chat. I see you guys. Drop some last minute questions in the chat. We'll probably wrap this live stream up here in a second.
Yeah, so we could go party it up with the rest of the Raider Nation, man.
We got a good crowd here, man.
We're just chilling, bro. This is a cool little setup, man. We just chilling on the couch, you know, with the Raider Nation, man.
I'm comfy, dude.
This is like a club, like a VIP club just for Raider fans, man.
Yeah.
I don't know who let the other guy in here, but.
Snyder emails.
Emails?
Mention the Snyder emails.
Oh! The emails, my guy. Shout out to producer Mike, man. I forgot all about that, man. Them emails, man.
I don't know, dude.
Hey, man. We were talking about it that Bears game, remember?
Yeah.
And we thought, like, you know, it's not going to be anything serious. Then the next day, Gruden freaking resigns from the team. Shout out to producer Mike again. That's something I did talk about. But, man, we got to get this Washington football team back for those emails, man. Is it kind of ironic how John Gruden's emails, out of 650,000 emails, was brought up? And then after he got fired, we don't hear about it anymore.
I don't know.
At all. And you know what's funny? John Gruden tried to sue the NFL, and that's when we went on our three-game losing streak.
Hey,
that's kind of that's a conspiracy for me. I was like,
penalties.
I said, John, bro, this is the wrong time for you to be suing the NFL. You know, the NFL, they're going to be acting different out there. But, yeah, them emails, bro.
It's payback for us now.
Oh, we got to get him back, man.
It's payback for us. We got some serious business. It's personal business right
it
now.
It is. I said in my pregame preview, it's not just win, baby. It's must win, baby. Tomorrow.
Oh.
We have to win tomorrow against this team, man.
Drop that in the chat. Spam it in the chat. Must win, baby.
Yes, sir. Let's get it, man.
Oh, I can't wait till we get off this. I'm gonna steal that and get on the DJ mic and let everybody know.
Hey, let them know, man. We got DJ
Mike Scott.
Yes, sir. Oh, man.
That's Philly Mike right there, man. Philadelphia right, Black Hole chapter right there.
Oh, is he really?
Yeah.
I didn't even know that.
Yeah, Mike Scott holds it down.
Mike who? Mike Scott.
Mike who?
Mike Scott.
You got anything else? You want
to
talk about?
I don't really got anything. Oh, what we got over here, man? Jay Leno, man, he says payback is good. Must win, baby. I got a couple of must win babies up in here, man. I see you guys up in here.
Coming.
I see you guys up in here. Jerry, Raiders 530. Diego.
Yeah, we got the delay a little bit, but must win, baby's definitely dropping in the chat.
You know it, man. We definitely got to go out there and win tomorrow, man.
Must win, baby.
7-5, man. Ooh, I see my boy Gorilla Rilla up in here, man.
Let's go. Man. We'll be getting in there. Where's Gorilla Rilla? Let's see if we can get him in the camera.
Yeah, there my boy Gorilla Rilla. Hey, man, I don't know.
Hey, Mark.
Yo! Let's go! Let's get it! Raiders! Let's get it! You see Gorilla Rilla up in the house? Let's go! Let's go! My guy, I ain't gonna lie, man. I don't know how he'd be up in that suit. I feel like it'd be hot up in there.
I know. How often do you wash it? Dry cleaners? How do you take care of that business?
Imagine
a dry cleaner like, man, again?
He said, what in the? No, I'm just joking. Hey, my guy, Gorilla, man. We out here. Let's go, man. Shout out to the chat. Glenn, I see you up in there, man. Payback on the Cowboys and payback on the football team. It's on. Let's go.
That's it, man.
Hey, we got to win, man. We got to win tomorrow, man.
Hey, we're going to close it out, man.
Sir.
Small Raider, man. Appreciate you, as always.
Hey, I appreciate you having me, man.
Always.
This is lit, man. We definitely got to do it again.
First of many, dude. We're doing this a lot. And there's so many Raider fans in here. I can't wait
for the next one. And like I said, if you are in Las Vegas still and you're watching this live stream and you bored at your house, not knowing what to do with your life, and you're like, man, I wish I could be there. Well, we're going to be here till midnight, so you can come on by and hang out with the Raider Nation the night we go.
Three and a half hours.
Yeah. The night before we go and whoop the Washington football team's candy asses out there. So, yeah.
WFT?
WFT or WTF?
They're going to be asking themselves that tomorrow. Raider Nation, appreciate you guys tuning in.
Shout out to
the
Raider Nation.
Make sure you subscribe to Samoan Raiders channel. I think I actually have it down in my description.
Yeah.
And if you're watching on Samoan Raiders, don't subscribe to mine because I'm
kind of a mess. Hey, subscribe to Raider Cody.
I'm a mess.
Listen to his podcast as well, man.
I'm a mess. I've been doing much content. I apologize
it's
for that.
It's all good, man.
We're chilling, man. We're busy.
Quality over quantity, right?
Hey, but we're out here in Vegas doing it, dude.
Hey, man, we're having fun in Vegas, man. I love it. It's my home away from home, man.
Yeah, shout out to the chat.
Yeah.
Tune in next time, man. And make sure you post-game show probably when you get home.
Yes, sir.
Absolutely.
Probably from my room. I don't know.
Hey. Good stuff. Raider Nation. That's all. Must win, baby.
Yes, sir. Must win. Let's get it.
Later. Sir. Bam.